So we can start with that. So we means like we can notice the pattern. For example, means like we have a triangle in which we have started with one. We have two more ones. Then after the third row, we can see the means like the pattern changing. And how it is changing is like we are getting a new except the boundary means like except the edges, we are getting new elements with the sum of the above two, right? So for example, this middle one, two, how did we get? We got it from the above side, means like from the just upper row, from the means like just attached two hexagonals. So from one and one, we got the two, and for the this three, we got from one and two, and for this three, we got two. Let it come again. So we got two and one from three, and then one and three, then four, three, three, six, and three and one, four. So we can see means like it is forming a kind of an list. I guess you guys will be are familiar with the list and 2D list, right? Like 2D arrays and all.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Cool. So let me what approach we can follow is like we can create an 2D list that is list of integer, and in our list we will be storing another list. So let's start. For example, this will be our first list. In that list, we will be storing one second. Yeah, we will be storing another list that will be having an element as one. Reduce the size to yeah. And after that, we will be storing we will be adding another list of integer. So we will be adding one and one there. So because we know, right, that it is already means like pretty much explained from what we can see, like this won't be changing, one and one. And after that we can proceed further. And what we can do, like we know the boundary condition means like the edges of this triangle is also not changing, so we can predefinedly put a one there. And then what we will do, we will go to the previous list what we just put it in, and we will take this two means like this is the zeroth index, this is the first index, right? So what we will do, we will add up this zeroth index and means like the minus. For example, if it is a j pointer, we will add 0. J minus one and the jth one. So what it will be? It will be one plus one. It will become two. And we know that edges are means like the edge of a triangle is again one. So we will add one again. And afterward, similarly, we will proceed further. We will create a new list of means like we will add in the existing list of integer. We will add another list in which we will be having one as a edge, and we will add let me erase it. Yeah, so we will be adding one here as an edge. Then we can go to previous list, and we will be adding, since we will be adding in the first index, right? It is an one second. Yeah, it is an zeroth index, and we added in j and j minus one. So what is our j? J at j in the previous list we had two, and in the j minus one we had one. So we will be adding three here, and then afterwards, one second. Yeah, afterwards we will be adding two and one. Why? Because j minus one is two and j is three. And we know that like in the edge of that triangle, the edge of this triangle, we have one, means like at the boundaries we are only having one. Similarly, we will get 1, 4, 6, 4, 1 also. let me explain through the code. I know means like it's quite confusing, but through the code, it will help you out. So what we did is like we created a new result list of integer, in which what happens is like we are storing our new list inside a big result. What they asked for the output, if they have given means like any output at num rows, like for example 5. So we have to construct a triangle of 5 rows, and we have to return list of integer. So inside a big list, we are having a small list. So what we did, we created a new list of integer. And also one thing, guys, I guess you all guys are comfortable in Java, or if any means like majority of you having any preferred language choice, please let me know also. If you don't get it, means like the syntax wise, although the logic will be same. So yeah, so let's go to another, means like let's proceed. So what we did, we put it up a boundary condition. For example, in the test case, they have mentioned that if num rows, like if they have given 1, and means like it will be having a list of integers in which we are having a list of list of integers in which we will be having 1 as in list, means like inside that list we will be having 1. So what I did, I just added in the our list of integer, that let's call it LL. It is a means like quite a hectic. So let's call it LL. So inside that LL, I added a new list which is having 1 as in means like which is having 1 as in parameter. So I just returned it, and after that, so we know like right what I means like mentioned. So we can see the pattern that in the first row, in the second row, we know that we have 1 and 1 and 1 means like in first row we have 1, and in the second row we have 2 1. So I already means like pre-process the data. So after that, let me remove this. And after that, we know that from third row onwards, we will be means like we will be calculating the correct manner, means like the correct output we have to get. So what I did, I put it up a for loop starting from I equals to 2. Why I equals to 2? We have to start from the third index. And afterwards, I created a temporary list in which I have added 1 as a pre-processed data, because we know in the edges we are having 1. And after that, I put it another for loop, for which what I did, I started from j equals to 1. Why j equals to 1? Because we know that the boundary means like we already added the boundary numbers, that is 1. And afterwards, we need to add 2, means like how we will calculate 2. So what I did, I added temp dot add, means like inserting another element into the list. And how did I did it? So I did result dot get I minus 1. What result dot get I minus 1 means the previous one dot get j minus 1. So j minus 1 means like let me one second. Yeah. And so j minus, so we had 1, 1, right? Let's move the box. 1, 1. This was the 0th index, and this was the 1st index. So I added, we know that at 0th index we have 1, and at the 1st index we have 1. So what I did, I result dot get I minus 1. So from we got the through this we got the previous list exists. Then through that I did get j minus 1. The previous means like just above the first element, or just the previous element just above that number. So through that I got this 1, and after that I added result dot get I minus 1 the previous list, and inside that previous leaf, we have another list. Through that, I access this one, dot get J1. And I added another one because we know the boundary are means like we are having one as in means like on the brown boundary. And after that, I have created this whole a new list and I have inserted that list inside our the main result list. So means like it will work for from 2 to whatever. For example, if it is 5, then it will work from 2 to 5. So we will create it, means like the list will get generated and we will get the expected result. So now doubts means like
could you please explain this portion once more, the for loop, the one that is inside j is equals to 1.
Can you give me the line number please?
Line number is 17.
Line number 17, yeah. Mm-hmm. Got it. So one second, let me open a notepad. Like what I did, I first added temp dot add 1, right? So I added 1. Now I came across this for loop. Why I started it with one because I knew that our boundaries are mainly of most means like are of ones only. So I just added 1 as a pre-processed data. Then afterwards I started this for loop, and then what I did. We know means like in that also they have mentioned that each number is 2 of numbers directly. Yeah. In Pascal's triangles, each number is the sum of two numbers directly above as it's shown. So what I did in the temp.add means like in the temporary list, what we are doing. So I added 1 plus 1 means like this was the 0th index and this was the first index. So we knew that like this 2 will get generated from just above the means like whatever the index is. So I added means like I accessed this list through result.get I minus 1. This is the result till now. Means like just if you can just imagine like we have a big list inside, we are storing some list again and again. So till now we have this output. So I access this list through I minus 1 and then I access the previous element like this element because whatever means like we have to insert the 2 means like inside the next number, right? Whatever it will come like X, for example. So how it will come, we know that it will be on the first index. We will go to the we'll add up the first index and the previous index. Why? Because we can show means like we can see in the diagram that it is also said that it is the sum of the 2 number directly above it means like the when hexagonal is joined. So it will be it can be predicted, right, that it will be above the 2 indexes. So I access that means like this element and this element. So it will become 2. Then after that, j equals to 1, j less than I. So for me, for the first round, it will be 2. So it will increment to j plus plus, that will become 2. We'll check the condition 2 less than 2. It won't happen. It will go down and it will throws to 1 means like it will add 1. Then afterwards our result, our updated result, the whole big list of integer, it will become this triangle, this element. Then after that we will again go to that, we will create a new temp list, we will add 1 there, then we know that it means like our for loop will start by our for loop will start with one, because we know other than boundary condition we have to calculate. So we will calculate that, and how we will calculate that, by looking just above that the 3 and 2. So we know that means like we can access this element because we stored in the result 2d means like list of integer. So we access that. Is it clear now?
Yes. To get I minus one, that is basically to get the list that is before it, and get j minus one is to access the values inside that list, right?
Yeah, correct.
Got
it. Okay. So if we run this, means like it will definitely work because I already did it. But the point is, means like you got it right, guys. And if you are having any doubt or any second thoughts, please let me know once.
Akshat, if the number of rows is 2, how it is going to work if the number of rows is 2?
Yeah. So we already, if you can means like notice that in line number 11, we already added for number rows 2, right? And what will happen if number rows is 2? I equals to 2, I less than equals to 2. It won't work, right? I less 2 is not less than equals to, 2 is not less than 2, right?
All right. Okay. Got it.
Yeah. So means like it will work out, and we can also check that it will work. Yeah. Any other doubt, guys? Okay. So
actually I was doing, I was checking the number of rows is 2. So above for loop itself, I was returning from there.
Okay.
Yeah, but your idea is good. Anyway, it will not go in the for loop, then it will come to the line number 23 and then it will return from here.
Yeah,
okay, thank you.
Yeah, no worries. Okay, so I guess the silence as a no means like we are clear with this.
Yeah, one more doubt here.
Yeah.
So instead of in the for loop line number is 15. So we can directly use the I equal to 0, right? And so, we can get rid of this if condition, and so we don't need to fill in that, even in the second row as well. If you start from 0, so directly we can fill it through the first row and second row also.
Yeah, we can means like also do that. So means like there are multiple options we can solve the questions. So this is one of the method. So means like it will also work if we don't want to pre-process the data. You are correct.
Yeah, that's what my question. Yeah, why don't we can
use okay. Yeah. So can we proceed to the next one, guys?
Actually, one last question.
In
this type of questions, will there be the time complexity of this solution?
Yeah. Yes. Sorry. Yeah. So the time complexity we can notice, right? One second. Let me get my pen to log in, and we can see, right, that means like this loop will mainly work from I equals to 2 to num rows, means like this loop will work for big of n, means like whatever our num rows will be, right? And after this j equals to 1 to j less than I, so how much time it will work, since we know that means like step by step, no doubt I will become num rows, right? So it will again become big of n. If we can, means like just imagine that it will, this for loop will also increase, means like simultaneously. So this complexity will become big of n square.
Yes. So is this complexity acceptable while we'll be taking?
Yeah. Yeah. So means like when you submit this, means like it will work, and I guess means like. I spent some time on this problem also, so I couldn't find any means like better approach, but I will still search it, and if I means like get it, I will let you know. But for means like I got this means like the optimized approach. Because otherwise we can also calculate like by putting up all the I equals to zero and I j equals to zero and all that. It's like just by going brute force approach.
Yeah, so I did the same when I equal to zero. It is a time complex. Yeah, it's a zero MS.
Okay, so yeah.